God the author of negativity? If not, is the source of negativity apart from God?
Beautiful. Okay.
And the second question is, if we are not the doer, why do we bear the responsibility for everything that we do?
Now, both these questions are based upon misconceptions. If divinity is omnipresent and within each and every cell of yourselves, then negativity is also a product of God. Who said God is just positive only? What we have to learn is to see the positive side of God and portray it in our lives. Who can call the rain to be negative and the sunshine to be positive? They both part and parcel of each other. If you have a cloudy day, who can say that the clouds are not important, although the clouds obscures the sun? But without those clouds which the sun itself has produced, there would be no rain, and you will have no food. So, all teachings, good teachings, would teach us to see both sides of the coin. How can you have a coin with one side only? You can't even buy a box of matches with it then, if it was only printed on one side. Mind you, it would be nice to find a coin with one side. Could become a collector's item. Do you see? But our duty is just to see the positive aspects of everything, because everything is positive. Even your negative thought, which you regard to be negative, is underlined with positivity. I'm feeling ill today and trembling because of my sugar problem. Okay. But I see a beauty in it. So, why should I not tremble? Because of my blood condition, diabetic, so I'm trembling, and what's wrong with it? I accept it to be positive. And not wallow. And say, oh, this is negative, negative, negative. So, although divinity is composed of positivity and negativity, but we want to see positivity only. And the reason is this, that we want to try and be happy. Because there is greater happiness and peace in positivity. And yet the word itself, the opposite of it, unhappiness. Can you see? It's just the un, huh? Still happy. Right. So, we can negate negativity. Just throw away the un. Okay, Bun? Just throw it away. And that is how we will see within ourselves everything positive, even in that which is negative. Someone slaps my face. Okay. Now that you regard to be negative. But I might be having a toothache, and that slap would perhaps cure that toothache. Huh? You see how we have to look at things so that all the negativity that surrounds us, or created by our thinking processes, the same energy can be used to bring it into positivity. So negate the negativity and position yourself in positivity. So everything we feel or we observe, every thought that arises in us can be taken to its true value. For everything is a product of peace. And even in negativity and positivity, peace is there. But being patterned, having conditioned minds, people tend to look at the worst side of things. Oh, it's a cloudy day. Yes, I observe the cloudy day. I see it's dark and gray, but yet I know the sun is behind it. If you fly in an airplane, the airplane goes beyond the clouds, and then what do you see? It's the sun. So go beyond the negative, so-called negative clouds of life. And that is what our teachings are all about. As we read Kavita's letter, she says what she actually means. There's a subtle transformation in her because of her practices, and she always feels peace within. Now that is the condition that has to be created within us by ourselves. Positivity can never exist without negativity, and negativity cannot exist without positivity. But where is your attention? That is important. And that attention is created by the mind. And then the mind thinks, I'm the doer. Well, you're not the doer at all. Everything in life is done for you. And I've said this many times before, you put in your 10% and the 90% comes automatically. So that little 10%, that's what we need. By channeling our thoughts towards betterment, channeling our thoughts towards sunshine. And yet there are clouds in the sky, but the sun, to repeat again, is existing beyond the clouds. Now, can we call the clouds negative and the sun positive? No. The clouds are created by the sun. It is the sun itself with its heat draws a water vapor to form those very clouds. And we complain of the gloomy day. Who says clouds are gloomy? Who says your thoughts are gloomy? Your thoughts are positive. Always, but you look at it through gloom. A jaundiced person will see everything yellow. So we get rid of the jaundice of our minds. And the greatest jaundice that man suffers from is thinking he's the doer. How can he be the doer? He won't be able to walk from here to that door. On your own? Without that divine energy that is within you, you can't even lift a hand. Do you see? Here we come back to the matter of attitude. What attitude do I have in life? And if every thought, positive or negative, has the element of love in it, then that negative thought soon passes away. Remember, it's the same energy you're using in a positive thought or a negative thought. It's the same energy. The emphasis might not be the same, and the emphasis is created by our patternings. So anything that's patterned can be unpatterned. It's like taking a piece of string and tying it around your finger. You do it this way, but you can also untie that piece of string You see? So every pattern of our minds can be given a different aspect to it. And that is your 10% as the doer in practical life. The rest, the other 90%, is done for you automatically. Now, if he is the doer of everything, then why should you worry? You leave it to him. Yes, God, do what the hell you want to do. I'm not going to care. And when you stop caring of the petty little things of life, you just get into a worst mess. So stop being a mess and stop messing around. Life is something so beautiful. It is really to be appreciated. When you appreciate love, life, then you know the meaning of love. And when you know the meaning of love, you know the meaning of divinity. It's the same. Everything is the same. I love a person more, he who hates me. I mean, there's no one in the world that hates me. They love me to pieces. You'd be surprised, I'm keeping myself together. Keep yourself together through the power of love. And therefore the scriptures, all scriptures say, love thy neighbor as yourself. But I would add on to that, not only your neighbor. Here's my neighbor. That's my neighbor. This is my neighbor. Let's see. So who is the doer? But I need to cognize. And that is why we've given this mind, the thinking ability which separates you from an animal. And what should the mind be thinking? That everything in this world is good. And when you recognize that everything is good, slowly the 1-0 in good will be rubbed away. It will fade away. And there's only God. The problem is the mind. And when you can transcend it, go beyond it, and watch it act, then there's another part of you that will tell you. This part of the heart will tell you, the mind is playing tricks. Let it have fun. Who cares? You become the observer, and then nothing can affect you. And what really observes is not you, but the real doer. He is also the observer. So when you reach that area of being able to observe objectively, then the mind will not affect you. It will not affect you because you have become non-attached from the mind. You let the mind perform. Let the mind do whatever it wants to do. To hell with it. And when that is ingrained within you, you would be pouring out that heart that is within you. A true master might analyze your mind But his greater job is to open your heart. And when the heart is open, you become more and more receptive to everything around you, because the heart only sees and feels and acts in goodness, which is godliness. Ain't God good, huh? He sure is. So, when we stop thinking of ourselves as the doer, what happens is this, that we are surrendering to a higher force which is in us and all around us. But the easiest place to start from is that place in us. Because if you have some cognition and recognition of what is in you, you will automatically project it to everything outside you. That is how one starts. That's how one starts. Until you feel that there is nothing outside you. Everything is inside you. So this is the process that you start off with duality, and you progress to qualified non-duality, and the last step is total non-duality. If everything is found to be within you, what can hurt you? Nothing can hurt you, because no one purposely would like to hurt themselves. Yes. And with this sense, one can find greater happiness and peace. Now, there are three things which you must indulge in: is sense, common sense, and nonsense. People think they don't even understand the word nonsense. We don't make sense of anything, and it's fun. The greatest humor in life is based on nonsense. And when you view it with common sense, you develop the real sense of what is nonsense. It's beautiful, beautiful. Yeah. So man should be a combination of all these three things: sense, common sense, and nonsense. And it's a greater art to be able to view nonsense with sense. You see the humor in it then. And you find the life to be filled with fun. Because you now have developed the sense and the common sense to see the nonsense, and nonsense is humor. And you become humorous. Not tumorous, humorous. For who wants a tumor on the brain? I think I must start doing operations on all of you. Cut away those tumors. See, it's a pressure on the brain. Unnecessary pressure. And that is why you find things going wrong or right, because of that pressure on the brain box. There's another way out. Instead of having a brain in the head, fill it with sawdust. Yes. Yeah. Then you won't be able to think all the rubbish you think about. Huh? Yes. But feel, feel, feel. Feel the joy, feel the beauty. Yes. And you will see with clear eyes all the beauty around you. Let me wipe my eyes. You know, I was telling someone, you know, the two most sensitive parts of me is my feet, the soles of my feet, and my eyes. You know why my feet has become so sensitive? It's because of walking around walking around the stupid world. And I can feel all the rubbish that's going on in this world. And that's why my feet are so sensitive. And why are my eyes so sensitive? Because I see all the rubbish around me, which should not be there. But it's helped me by feeling with the feet and seeing with the eyes. It has helped me to become more and more compassionate. And it has made me more and more kind. It has made me feel more that if you have a headache, I feel your headache. If you have a toeache, I feel it too. And if you have a bottom ache, there's another word for that. I feel that too. It's a bit cold, isn't it? Huh? Tonight we must remember to bring a blanket down. No, you need that, darling. No, you need it. Aren't you using that?
We have a sweatshirt.
Can we take care of her or what?
Thank you. You see, I was feeling cold, and now you guys are trying to heat me up. Look at the contrast. And aren't both beautiful? Nothing wrong with coldness. It is nature. And nothing wrong with heat. So you accept them equally, with equal eyes. And when you can see things with equal eyes, you become one-pointed. And when one is one-pointed in any endeavor, life becomes more happy. So scatterbrains, gather yourself together. Every sentence I would speak is a poem in itself. And poetry is something that wells up within you. It's not the mind at work, it is the heart at work, expressing itself spontaneously. And that is what we need. That's what we need. That spontaneity of life, where we just flow, and flow very gracefully. And when you flow through life gracefully, you attract more and more grace to yourself. That's your 90%. Do you understand? Your 10% is just to be gracious. And that 90% of grace just dawns onto you. It does not wait to come in by the door. No. It's always waiting at the door. And your 10% is in opening the door to let it in. If the room is stuffy, what do you have to do? You just have to open the window. And the air, fresh air, will come in by itself. You don't need to go and call it. Like another analogy I've used somewhere, I don't know where. You don't need to go and chase butterflies all over the field. Make your garden beautiful, and the butterflies will automatically come. Yes, there. Yeah. And that is how life is lived. That is how the beauty of life is received. Then you say, in gratitude, in thanksgiving, that Lord, you have been so merciful to me. The trials and tribulation anyone goes through is created by themselves, by their own little minds, of which they use very little. Because if they had to use more and more of the mind, then they would be able to comprehend everything, become aware of everything. And in that awareness, going a little step further, you'd find everything to be so, so beautiful. When you see things around you to be beautiful, then you attain unto yourself greater and greater beauty. How aware are you? Now don't look up. How many lights are in this room?
Four.
11. I'm the 12th one. He's counting, Paddy. Yes, yes. That's what it's all about. Everything can be created into fun and laughter. You can be very serious in the wisdom you impart, but at the same time, you also know how to laugh. Now we're coming back not to the tumor, but to human. Yes, that is the way life is lived. I've only done 45 minutes. I'm cutting it a bit short. I'm not feeling too well. I'm trembling a bit. We'll make it up tonight. Okay then. Thank you.